The most sophisticated people that I know are nervous about this subject. God is the one who created this. Why? So this morning, I'd like to talk to you about death. For a lot of reasons, which you'll find out later, it's pretty pertinent right now. Death is something that sophisticated people ignore. They avoid. Death is something that God created. Why? Well, let's start at the beginning. God created the heavens and the earth. He created all this life. Book of Genesis, if it has any historical value to you, is filled with just the most amazing story that God spoke to Moses, spoke to Adam, spoke to Noah, and told them this is what happened. Life everywhere. In fact, so much life that God said, Adam, Eve, here's the tree of life, and here's the tree of death. If you eat thereof, you're going to die. So what did Satan do? He said he capitalized on Adam's and Eve's choices before they even made it. And he jumped in quick as a jackrabbit or as a snake and said, oh, the tree of the knowledge of good and evil. Oh, if you eat that, you're going to be as smart as God. And he doesn't want that. And he incited deceit and treachery and rebellion. It wasn't God's desire that Adam and Eve died, but it was his desire not to live with people in rebellion, not to live with people that had the same DNA as Satan, the same proclivity to rebel and to do things their way and to make their own rules. Satan, Lucifer, was a created angel that had decided to do his own thing, and he wanted company. How much better, Adam and Eve? And so, with rebellion in their heart, they both ate and rejected life. That's just amazing. And that life is from the one who gave it. The life is from the one who created us. That life belongs to the person who calls himself our Father, which art in heaven. Hallowed be thy name. Our life, according to the historical Jewish and Christian tradition, it belongs to God and everything comes from him. So which is more important? Which is something that's more in God's mind? Death? Is God more concerned about death or rebellion? According to the Genesis, it seems like rebellion is more important to him. He was begging Adam and Eve to eat from the tree of the life. Set it in the middle of the garden, right next to the other one. But what did the salesperson Satan do? Ooh, this one's on sale. And it tasted and looked better than the other. And that's what rebellion does. Deceit and rebellion tricks people into thinking that death is easier to deal with than rebellion. But not in God's word. You'll see all through the Old Testament and New Testament that God is looking for faithful people. And yesterday I spent quite a bit of time with my amazing renter, bent over backwards to help me move a huge, heavy stove, gigantic wood stove. Didn't have to. He wanted to. And as we were visiting, and this subject came up about being faithful. And we had both met people that had grown up in church and were reading their Bibles most of their life and praying, but because they weren't faithful, their rebellion was more alive, even while they were going to church, and even while they were reading the Bible, and even while they were praying, and even while they were being sophisticated with great thoughts, because their rebellion, because they could not obey and would not obey God on the simplest things of forgiving their enemies, loving their kids and loving their wife and doing a good job at work. You know, there was just consistent points where they just did things their way instead of doing things God's way. There was no faithfulness in their life that it produced separation and death, and it was like a rebellious child that wants to be a part of a family, wants all the benefits, but doesn't want to do anything that the parents say or be a blessing to the other siblings in a way that's speaking the truth and love to them, even when it sometimes hurts. I think we've all seen children like that, that wants all the candy but none of the chores. And those types of children are very hard to get close to. They only want their friends with their fancy clothes or their fancy music or their fancy activities. All they want is something that produces their own family of rebellion. And just like Satan, rebellion loves company. Life is a little bit different. I've found that most people that are after a life at peace with God through being justified by being, we therefore have peace with God through faith. We're justified by faith. We have peace with God through our Lord Jesus Christ. Whew, there, finally got it. That's what Romans 5 says. Therefore, being justified by faith, we have peace with God through our Lord Jesus Christ. That really ends the rebellion. When you put down your own way, when you put down the tools of your warfare against disagreeing with God and saying, well, I'm going to try things your way. 6 months, let's just do this. Let's just live by what we see in the New Testament. You'll be shocked. You'll be shocked at what you find out. That there really is a possible way to have life with God here on earth. That the New Testament is not some fairy tale that's like Aesop's fairies that just give good principles and good ideas for the very slavery and womanly people out there that just need some good comfort and some good stories of Shakespeare. Hee hee hee. But it actually is possible to live for Jesus. That's what the Romans who died in the Colosseums found. That's what the Jews who found died in Jerusalem when the Jews continued to kill Christians. They didn't have to continue to live at peace with God and be enemies with people. They could have just easily renounced Jesus and got along and, you know, come on, love your neighbor as yourself. What's wrong with you? But instead, what we see is that people that choose life, the rebels hate that. They desire to get rid of that. They think that it's judgmental and rude. So learn to forgive your enemies. Learn to lay down your life for people that oppose you. It will happen. And it will happen in strange ways. People that you thought were at peace with you, the moment you start speaking about victory over rebellion, victory over sin, and that's more important than victory over death, even if you have relatives that are passing away, even if you have friends that are passing away. And the older you get, the more that's what you're going to see. But I'm telling you, you should be, in your own life, more concerned about rebellion against God and being able to teach people clearly how to get victory over rebellion towards God. And that will take care of the death problem, because we're all going to die. It's 100% guaranteed. Everyone listening to this, you will have your day. Some will see it coming. Others, it will be a total surprise. Neither will escape this. So focus on what it is that's important. If God is more concerned about rebellion so that you can have life, then focus on that. Don't worry about your death. Worry about how much rebellion you have in your life, and that's measured by how obedient you are to what you see in the New Testament. It is there in clear black and white so that you can study it and figure it out. It's not some reincarnated book like what we keep running into at Homeless Feeding. Two Rivers is, I just believe in reincarnation. What, are you kidding? You're going to trust the opinion of your own feelings and maybe some one book that you've read over a book that's been around for 2,000 years and has been critically scrutinized by everyone And it's been found historically accurate, and it's been found historically true that Jesus rose from the dead and escaped death. I mean, we're talking about an expert here, an expert witness that has overcome rebellion but from God by being willing to do whatever the Father in heaven says, even after three times saying, hey, can I not have to go to the cross? Not my will be done, but yours be done. If Adam and Eve would have done that with the devil and said, Lord, we're not sure about what this slick salesperson's telling us. Can you help us figure it out? Because we're foggy in the brain right now. He would have come and helped straighten them out, and they would have been able to crush Satan right then and there. You can as well. You can draw near to God through Jesus Christ, who is our brother, who is our loyal and faithful brother, who is part of the family of God, and you can trust him. And he will show you how to be justified, just as if you'd never sinned. And he'll fill you with his Spirit so that you too can see clearly that blessed are those of the pure in heart, for they shall see God and have peace with him. And peace with God means life. For the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. Check out Romans sometimes if you're interested in what I'm talking about. Lord bless you.